that they were very afraid and upset that their government was not ready. And of course, they had all sorts of commissions looking into why that was true. But the public was certainly aware of it. Because as you know, they have a citizens army. So every family, many families were affected by the call-ups.
ב-12 באוקטובר, היום השביעי לקרבות, המציאות מעמידה את הנהגת ישראל מול מלחמה קשה משצפו. אויב עקשני מזה שידעו ב-67, בלי אור בקצה המערכה. מאזן הדמים של קרבות הבלימה כבד.
Israelis were shocked and frightened. They did not believe that this could happen to them. The Israeli citizens saw on television images of Israeli soldiers kneeling on the sand with their hands behind their back, with the Egyptians standing over them in victorious. The Israeli citizens were furious at Moshe Dayan, the Israeli defense minister, for letting this happen. The Israeli military realized they had made an enormous mistake in sending their tanks into battle against the Egyptians without infantry support. They lost hundreds of tanks. All of a sudden, for the first time, the Israelis felt vulnerable.
Israel's experience of 1973 shocked Israel and forced Israel to make changes. The Israelis are, you know, tearing their hair out, trying to understand what they got wrong, why they were surprised by the Egyptians, both in terms of the decision to go to war, but also in how the Egyptians fought the war. And so there is just an enormous firestorm in Israel over who got what wrong and why, and people are fired, and the Israelis realize that they can never afford to do that again.
האם יש בכוחו של צהל להתאושש ממכת הפתיחה הכואבת? האם יוכל לשנות את פני המלחמה? האם תעמוד ישראל במחיר הדמים? אחרי 7 ימי בלימה והתגוננות, בישראל מבקשים הפסקת אש שמשמעותה דגל לבן.
الآن علم الإسرائيليون وقت أن تساقطت طائراتهم بسبب حائط الصواريخ القاسي أن هزيمتهم بدأت قبل هذا التاريخ عندما استهانوا بشعب أراد الحياة بكرامة وجيش نفض عن كبريائه غبار النكسة